Part 27 of ASP.NET MVC series. Today we are going to learn how can we use NoAction attribute in our action before our action methods in our controllers to make it make that action to be not redirected even if that URL is requested. So let me show you the current execution of the project. I have created this books controller in previous video. So let's we invoke this action method or any action method of this controller. Like I will create a new book. Let me show you. If I run the project and let me show you, the create action method is now working. But if we place no action attribute before the definition of this action method will no longer be available to be executed. So let me quickly go to the books controller index action method, or we can definitely go from here because this we added this link in the previous video. So let me click on create. Now you can see this action method is being executed, but let me go back and let me apply no action attribute before this action method, and in the IntelliSense you can see represent no action attribute represents an attribute that is used to indicate that a controller method is not an action method. So for the sake of understanding, I have made this action method no action to make you people understand what can no action attribute can do. In future you can use this no action attribute for some reason, like you wanted to create an action a method in controller which you do not want to be executed via URL. I will show you in a moment. Please wait a while. Let me go to books slash index. Now if I mouse hover on this link, you can see I will redirect to you can see in bottom left corner I will redirect to books slash create, and we have made that action method no action. Now MVC is saying that there is no resource found for this URL. So guys, that is technically true because we have made it no action and we do not want this action method to be executed via URL. We can call it here in programmatically, but this action method can never be called or can never be executed via the URL request. Now if I delete it and if I again run it, this will work now. So previously we were redirecting to this action method. Now we again want to redirect to this action method, and let me check whether this is working or not. So let me show you one thing. Let me go back to books index action method and let me show you. Here is that, guys. Now it's working fine. Now let me go back to our controller and let me add one more method here, public string. Like in future, for some reason we made this action method for the sake of performing some business logic, but we do not want this test action method to be executed via the URL request. We want to use it here. Let me return some string here. This is test action method and we do not want it to be okay. That was fine, and we do not want it to be executed via URL request. So for now, because we have not added no action before this action before this method, this action method will also be executed. Let me show you. I will go to books slash test and you will see, because we are in books controller. And if I write the URL books slash test, this will be executed. Let me write that URL here, books slash test, and you will see this string is being returned by this action method, and there is no point in redirecting to such kind of URL. So for that reason, we make over such action methods, we decorate such action methods or action methods with no action attribute. Now if I save it, now you will see the same URL books slash test will never be executed. So let it run. Let me show you again. We go to books slash test action method and it will say that there is no resource located at this URL. This is technically true because now we have made this method as no action. So these action methods can be used in future for some reason, like if you have some business logic here that contains many lines of code, then your action method will grow in length and in number of lines. So you will preferably be doing you will be splitting your action methods code in functions. So like if I let me put some example. Let me go back here to make you people understand. I cut it here. Let me make a variable, some variable like it was books, number of books were being returned here, and I may make a variable. Let me pass this here as books, and now let us assume that here we have many lines of code and we want these lines of codes to be called from another action method, and we want another method from this controller, and we do not want that method to be redirected by a URL. Let me refactor this. Where is refactor? Where is that? Quick actions and refactoring, and I extract a method, and this method will be looking like this: private list book and new method. And if I hit enter, this will be added here. So guys, one way is to make your action private, but let me make it public, and this will now be executed via the URL. And now if I execute it, this method is returning list of books, and books has got that value, and we are passing it here. So one method is to make this action method or method private, and other way is to, if you are making it public, you have to use it no action attribute. So one may say that when the private variable is here, and why you use no action attribute? So guys, let me explain you. If this action method is being used by many controllers, then you know private action methods can only be accessed within that class. So if that is the scenario, you will have some problem if you have put private here. So that is why we use no action. No action will restrict it to not be redirected via URL, but it is even though accessible via other controllers. So that's it guys for this tutorial. Have a great day.